stayed downstairs.
Oh, yours are downstairs.
Yeah, yeah. I need my shoes.
Not even the boys.
Sorry, Skylar. Okay. Skylar, Damien, can you come over here, baby? Okay. Skylar, over here.
I'm already in my phone.
Yeah, it's fine, Hayden.
Try to put it on. Okay? Okay, let me put your.
What's good, kid?
Hey, look at who's here! What are you doing?
What's going on, brother?
Oh, that's why.
How you feeling, brother?
I'm good, I'm good. You know, chilling. Ready for this?
It's my man.
Ready.
Hey, you guys. Let's do it. We here.
My big girl.
Look. Tia. Smile, baby.
Hey, Bobby.
He can't even do it right now. He can't even bear it.
Oh, my God.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity from Lewis and Carla's wedding ceremony.
So we have gathered here today to celebrate one of life's greatest moments and give recognition to the worth and beauty of love and to add our best wishes to the words that shall unite you in marriage. You both remember that happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say I love you. It is having a mutual sense in values and common objectives. It is standing together facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing things for each other, not in the attitude or duty or sacrifice, but gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not expecting the husband to have a halo or the wife to have the wings of an angel. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. it is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, the dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. Lewis and Kayla, do you take Kayla as your friend in love, beside her and apart from her, in laughter and in tears, in conflict and tranquility, asking her to be your wife in all the ways that life may find you? And Kayla, do you take Lewis as your friend in love, beside him and apart from him, in laughter and in tears, in conflict and tranquility, asking him to be your husband in all the ways that life may find you?
Kayden.
Do you want to give this ring to mommy? Give the ring to mommy. Do you want to give this ring to daddy? Nope, it's his turn. I give you this ring as a sign
of my love and affection. As a ring, as a ring, neither does my love for you.
Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. And it does not take offense. It is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's faults, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse. It is trusting, and there is hope. It's always ready to endure whatever comes. True love does not come to an end. Lewis and Kayla, if each of you will take responsibility for the quality of your life together, you will continue to find happiness in your marriage. May you love, honor, and cherish each other for ever keeping the vows made here between you today. And by the virtue of these promises and vows, and the power conferred upon me by the laws of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your hand.
I know, but just walk with women. Don't worry about it, just walk.